Riley, what is better than one animated Lotus Field?
Oh, I'd have to say a second animated Lotus Field, Dennis, but Noxious, this may not work out the way he wanted it to.
Yeah, I thought this one about 80% of the way through, and of course now has to sacrifice two lands again.
Oh, dear, you hate to see it. Yeah, so the Lotus Field not coming to play with any counters on it, and also causing you to sacrifice your other land. Yowza. But Dennis, it's good to see him taking it in stride. Big smile on his face. Look, this happens to the best of us.
Oh, dude. Oh. Oh, God.
Riley, Desi here can have a little bit of an agility check on his slime vine trying to hit this Trollbed Guardian.
I really think this is how they should code Hexproof onto Arena. Just add an extra level of fun to the game here. I like this.
Jeez. Whoa, bro. Hey, calm down. Calm down there, Guardian. Jeez. Oh my god.
Riley, what do you want to tell us what happened here with you and Martin Yuza?
Nah, not really, Dennis. We can honestly just move on to the next clip. Honestly,
let's hold in here.
Not too much to see here. Oh, look, all right.
You're sitting on a comfortable nine life. You're going to gain a little bit of life this turn too, yeah?
Yeah. Look, Martin pulled through together a burn deck. I had a life gain deck. Pretty good matchup for me, I would have thought. As I start to gain life on 9, gain 1, go to 10, and completely unaware of the copy, or two copies, of Hidetsugu's second right in Martin's hand.
The best part about this is that Martin says to you, he's like, look at my hand already, see the card I just drew? As in implying that he's top deck the Hidetsugu's second right. I don't know what's more BM, top decking it or just still having all these, already having had one. It's all bad.
I mean, he absolutely gave it. What a bully. MPL bully destroys casual, young, hopeful Magic player once again. The rich get richer.
Riley, it's one thing to call a shot for what you're going to get off the top of your own deck, but calling what your opponent's going to get is pretty rare, and in this case, pretty brutal for old Mengu.
Yeah, as we see Brand Maggot take out the copy of Bond of Flourishing, Mengu needs to dodge exactly Castle Garenbrig, because otherwise that Carnage Tyrant will come down, trigger the Sarkhan's Unsealing, and blow up his entire board. And lo and behold, Dennis!
There it is. I feel so bad for Mengu here. Heart in his sleeve, the poor bloke.
Ma Dio caro, I knew it was going to happen! Ma non ci credo.
Tale as old as time here, Riley. Narset and drawing extra cards doesn't usually go quite this south, though.
No, right. Like, usually you go to draw a card and you don't, and so it doesn't matter. It's like, oh, whoops, forgot about it. But yeah, casting a brainstorm effect into a Narset, youch. Oh, this is really gonna hurt.
Well, I don't know. At least Bloody gets to decide which card's gone to the top of the library.
I mean, yeah, she can choose to draw either the Island or the Rob of the Rich next turn, but that is... I mean, Narset has delivered some savage pummelings in her time, but this one, wow, this one takes the cake.
No, that is a brutal beating for her. Thank you for watching, everyone. If you have your own suggestion for MTG Top 5, tweet them using the hashtag MTG Top 5 or post them on the Channel Fireball Discord server in the hashtag MTG Top 5 chat room.